So, as we said, improvisation comes from knowledge. It's not something just random, but it's something which has to be not planned, but you need to be prepared for it. So, for example, which elements are there in a solo? And then we will see that there we have choosing notes, which means, if, for instance, if I am in D minor on the losing cadence. Scales I could play. Scales I could play in this key that makes sense with the chords I'm playing. So then I can choose to use modes, to use modal things, or minor melodic, minor harmonic, whole tone scale, different things. So therefore, I need to know which notes I will choose. This means that over a certain chord, for instance, although the Andreessen cadence is not coming from any modal scale, because no mode produces the cadence chords as they are, still, we can use the modal scales for the cadence. That's a different thing. That's what Paco said. And therefore, automatically, for instance, if we say we're playing in D minor here and we use the F, say F major scale, based on the calculation which we do, the most basic one, we have first degree flat 7, flat 6, flat 7, flat 9, or D minor C7, B flat. And then if we use here a major scale from the flat 6 of this chord, of the 5th, 7, flat 9 chord, from this chord, then we will see that we have F major. And when we play that scale, when we play that scale over these chords, although we are not planning to change mode, it happens automatically, because then over D minor we will be playing the Aeolian mode, or minor natural scale. Over the flat 7 we will be playing the mixed Lydian scale. Over the flat 6 we will the Lydian scale, and over the 5th, 7th flat 9 we'll be using the Phrygian scale. So that just the chords are changing and you're not doing anything, but this is one way to approach it. So therefore, anyway, the thing is that you choose one kind of a scale that you want to use, and for that, of course, you need to know some scales there. Otherwise, you're random to choose. Say, you cannot choose just from very few options, then it will sound, your music will not have many colors there. So and therefore, the wider this is the spectrum of scales you can use, up to the Scriabin scale or anything, the better. And then first we need to know which scale we use, this is choosing notes aspect. Then we will talk about the other aspects on the next videos.
Y luego que descubrí ahí la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería, cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.